Get those muscles firing, man! This is important! Hey, defense, come on, man! This man has some spirit and some juice! We want more for you! The coach is doing. So the coach has got demand from you. You got demand out of each other.
Jaguars head coach Gus Bradley mic'd up for the opening of organized team activities. Look for the full Jags Wired segment later this week on Jaguars.com. And welcome to Inside the Jaguars, presented by FanDuel. J.P. Shadrick with you. The Jaguars back on the practice field Tuesday, the first of 10 OTA practices, then a mandatory minicamp in the fourth week coming up. But good to see the Jags back on the field today, and a first opportunity for quarterback Blake Bortles to work with his updated mechanics in a team environment. And for the second-year quarterback, learning a new offense in the film room is one thing. Putting it together on the field will be the challenge the next few weeks.
You know, sometimes as coaches, you get out there and you think, okay, we got to fix this in a day. And it hasn't been like that. It's been little bits and pieces. And I think because of that, Blake's, he has more ownership in it. And he's not there yet, but we've just seen really good improvement.
I mean, it's definitely still something that I have to think about, you know, which is cool to go through, you know, individual and group work and stuff like that, where you're just worried about throwing. Then you go to team and you kind of, you stop thinking about that and you start thinking about plays and defenses and where you got to go with the ball. So there's, you know, a time and a place to work on those fundamentals and then a time and a place to kind of just work on, you know, the schematic of things.
Other notes from Tuesday's first OTA practice. Paul Posluszny, linebacker, back on the practice field, coming off that torn pectoral muscle suffered last season. He's good to go. Wide receiver Marquise Lee was out Tuesday, nursing a knee injury suffered in phase two of the offseason program a little while back. And former Jags linebacker Russell Allen attended practice today. He's currently an assistant high school coach in California. We welcome in Jaguars.com senior writer John Osier. Let's start with Blake Bortles. New mechanics and a new offense to work with today.
Well, first day OTAs, he's obviously the story. And everybody you talk to in the locker room, Mercedes Lewis, some of the younger guys, Alan Hearn, said, clearly he showed a tighter spiral. He did the things that you wanted to see this first day. Mercedes Lewis said, yeah, we could see the footwork. I wonder how much of the footwork the other players can really see out there. But the benefit that they wanted to see, ball getting there quicker, they say they saw it. Good first day on that front for Blake Bortles.
He's got a new target too. Julius Thomas showed some flashes of why he's the highest paid tight end in the league.
Well, and although there's a limit on what we can actually say, I'll hint that he did look really good out here. And he's all those things that you wanted, the athleticism, the ability to catch the ball. I'm not saying if we saw it or not, but we did not see it. How about that?
How about that? Indeed. 89 out of 90 players are here for the, at least for the first OTA. Mm-hmm. Only one not here is Chris Clemens, the defensive end. Is that a big deal? It's voluntary.
You know, if it was somebody else or if it was unexpected, I think it might be a bigger deal. Mm-hmm. Talking to Sinderick in there, there just wasn't much of a reaction in terms of, oh man, he should be here, he should be here. I think Gus Bradley clearly knew when they signed Chris Clemens last year that this sort of thing is a possibility. He did it with Seattle. And I'll share one story. I was covering Indianapolis long, long time ago. Edgerrin James didn't go to OTAs. And he said, you know, I only went to 2 years of college, but I was there long enough to know what voluntary means. You know, classic Edgerrin quote, but very much the case of these things are voluntary. It's important to remember that. It's 4 weeks right now. I don't think it'll set Chris Clemens back. Don't think it's that big of a deal, although it'll be a big deal for the next couple of days.
One down, nine to go, John. Get ready.
Nine and then some mini camps in the end.
Yeah,
so we're here
too.
For the duration.
Here we go. The next 4 weeks, the Jaguars will be on the field. We'll be back tomorrow with post-practice coverage. It's Inside the Jaguars, presented by FanDuel.